Laudetur Jesus Christus, praise be Jesus Christ. It is the 23rd of October 2022. In the church liturgical calendar, we celebrate today World Mission Sunday. Welcome to the broadcast of the recitation of the Angelus, coming to you live from St. Peter's Square here in the Vatican. Pope Francis will soon lead the traditional Marian prayer of the Angelus from the Apostolic Palace. At the end of the recitation, as he always does, the Holy Father will impart his apostolic or papal blessing on all of us, including those of you who are watching or listening to this broadcast, wherever you are. My name is Father Paul Samasumo. On behalf of Vatican Media, I would like to acknowledge all of you who are following us on the various social media channels or are linked to our website of vaticannews.va. Some of you are tuned in to shortwave radio or your diocesan radio station. Welcome all. Allow me, however, to acknowledge our official partner radio stations and television stations of Catholic Television, Catholic Faith Network, Shalom World Television Networks, Shalom TV India, EWTN Television, Salt and Light Television, Atmadashan TV, our listeners of Luminous Radio, and those of Radio Maria England. You will find more information and details of the Angelus today on our website, vaticannews.va. No doubt those of you who are watching televisions have seen in the square a big imagine that has been shown. This is being carried by the Peruvian community, a resident in Italy. They have been processing today through the city of Rome for what is known in Peru as the Lord of Miracle Processions. In the processions, this painting, which you have seen on your television, is the famous image of Jesus on the cross painted by an Angolan slave in Peru way back in 1651. The artwork also depicts the Blessed Mother and Mary Magdalene. The artwork survived the devastating earthquake of 1655, which destroyed most of Lima. But it is also been revered and venerated for the many miracles that many Peruvians and people world over have endured and have seen and witnessed. As I mentioned briefly at the beginning, today also the Universal Church is marking World Mission Sunday. It is the Sunday that every Catholic community in the world celebrates annually. In fact, the whole month of October is Mission Month. You shall be my witnesses is this year's theme chosen by Pope Francis. On World Mission Sunday, the world's parishes, institutions, and even schools come together in prayer and solidarity. Perhaps we're not being called to pack our bags and travel to the ends of the world as missionaries, but however, by virtue of our baptism, we are all called to be missionaries. And now you see and you can hear the applause from the pilgrims in St. Peter's Square as they see Pope Francis arrive at the window to begin the Angelus. Dear brothers and sisters, buongiorno. The Gospel of today's liturgy presents us a parable with two protagonists, a Pharisee and a publican, that is, a religious man and an avowed sinner. Both of them go up to the temple to pray, but only the publican truly lifts himself up to God, because he humbly descends into the humility of himself and presents himself without any mask and with all his poverty. We could actually say this parable lies between movements expressed by two verbs, to rise and to descend. The first movement is to rise. Indeed, the text begins by saying two people went up to the temple area to pray. This aspect recalls many episodes in the Bible where, in order to encounter the Lord, one goes up to the mountain of his presence. Abraham goes up to the mountain to offer the sacrifice. Moses goes up to Mount Sinai to receive the commandments. Jesus goes up the mountain where he is transfigured. To rise, therefore, expresses the need of the heart to detach itself from a dull life in order to go towards the Lord, to rise up from the plateau of our ego, to ascend towards God, to gather what we live in this valley, to bring it up before the Lord, to rise. When we pray, we rise up. But to live this encounter with Him, with God, and to be transformed by prayer, to rise up to God, a second movement is necessary, to descend. Why? What does it mean? What does this mean? To rise towards Him, we must descend within ourselves, to cultivate the sincerity and humility of the heart that gives us an honest outlook on our frailties and poverty within. Indeed, in humility, we become capable of bringing what we are to God without pretense. The wounds, the sins, and the miseries that weigh us down in our hearts. And we invoke His mercy so that He may heal us, restore us. It's Him who can raise us up. The more we descend with humility, the more God raises us up. Indeed, the publican of the parable humbly stops at a distance. He doesn't come near. He is ashamed. He asks for forgiveness, and the Lord raises him up. Instead, the Pharisee exalts himself, self-assured, convinced that he is fine and upstanding. He begins to speak with the Lord only of himself, praising himself, listing all his good religious works, and disdaining others. I'm not like that one there. Because this is what spiritual arrogance does. Why do you speak us about spiritual arrogance? Because all of us are in danger of following in this. It leads us to believe yourself righteous and judge others. Spiritual arrogance is always thinking I'm better than others, better than that one. And in this way, without realizing, you adore your own ego and obliterate your God. It is a coming out which comes to oneself. It's prayer without humility. Brothers and sisters, the Pharisee and the publican concern us closely. Thinking of them, let us look at ourselves. Let us confirm whether in us, as in the Pharisee, there is the conviction of one's righteousness that leads us to despise others. It happens, for instance, when we seek compliments and always make a list of our own merits, list of our good works, when we concern ourselves with how we appear rather than how we are, when we let ourselves be trapped by narcissism and exhibitionism. Let us be aware of narcissism and exhibitionism based on vain glory that leads even us Christians, priests, and bishops always to have the word I on our lips. I, always I. I have done this, I have wrote that, I said it, I understood it before you, and so on. Where there is too much I, there is too little God. In my country, we call this we call them I for me, with me, only for me. That's what we call them in my country. Once, Si parlava di un prete. We're talking about a priest
centrato in se stesso,
who is always taken up by himself, and the people always said about him that one, when he does incense, he turns the incense board around to incense himself. He is incensing himself rather than God and appears ridiculous. Let us ask the intercession of Mary, most holy, the humble servant of the Lord, the living image of what the Lord loves to accomplish, overthrowing the powerful from their thrones and raising the humble. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary,
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ecce ancilla Domini.
Fiat mi secundum verbum tuum.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu mulieribus et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Et verbum caro factum est.
Et habitavit in nobis.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu mulieribus et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ora pro nobis, Santa Dei Genitrix.
Digne officiamur promissionibus Christi.
Gratiam tuam, quae sumus Domine, mentibus nostris infunde, qui angelo annunciante, Christi fili tui, incarnationem cognovim, per passionem eius et crucem, a resurrectionis gloriam perducamus. Per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Pro fidelibus defuntis requiem aeternam dona eis Domine.
Et lux perpetua lucia Deis.
Requiescant in pace.
Amen.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum.
Ex hoc nunque tusque in saeculum.
Aiutorium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Qui fecit caelum et terra.
Benedicat vos omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen. Amen.
So we just received the papal blessing after reciting the Angelus in Latin. Now, dear brothers and sisters, we celebrate today the Universal World Mission Sunday, whose theme is You Shall Be My Witnesses. This is an important occasion for us to renew our baptismal promises and to participate in the mission of the world through our testimony and announcing the gospel. I encourage all of you to sustain missionaries with your prayers and with concrete solidarity so that they can continue to evangelize the world in the entire world. Today, we open the official registration for the 37th World Youth Day, which will take place in Lisbon in August 2023. I've invited here with me two young Portuguese people. There they are. As the Pope announces the official opening of the registration for World Youth Day. They are here with me as I also register as a pilgrim for World Youth. And there the Holy Father on a tablet, carried by a young person, clicks on the tablet, and he is registered as the first World Youth Day pilgrim, which will take place in August 2023 in Lisbon, Portugal. With him are those two young people whom he has invited from Portugal. There. Remain here. Dear young people, I invite you to join this gathering, which after a long period due to the isolation of the COVID-19, we now rediscover the joy of fraternal embrace between people and between generations. It is an embracing of reconciliation for which we have need. Yesterday, in Madrid, the church has new 12 blessed. Vincenzo Nicasio, Renuncio Toribio, and 11 other companions were killed in 1936 in the Civil War. Their beatification helps us also to be courageous and also to spread the gospel in the world. An applause for the two new blessed, for the 12 new blesseds led by Vincenzo Nicasio Renuncio. I'm also following the war in Tigray in Ethiopia and say that war with violence does not solve anything, just worsens the consequences. I appeal to all political leaders so that there will be solutions to reduce the suffering in the whole country, that they will favor dialogue so that there will be reconciliation.
Non manchino ai fratelli e alle sorelle etiopi così duramente provati la nostra preghiera, la nostra solidarietà.
We pray for our brothers and sisters in Ethiopia with our prayers and also with concrete solidarity. And I'm sad and offer my closeness to the floods that are affecting many African countries and many of those who are being affected by these floods. I would like to greet all of you, the Roman pilgrims from various countries, and also those from Indonesia who are and the Peruvian community who celebrate the Lord of Miracles Feast procession.
Saluto I fedeli di San Donato di Piave, Padova, Pontedera.
From Padova.
I ragazzi della Cresima di Piacenza.
The youth from Piacenza.
Non violento di Verona.
Oggi. Today. Inizio di un nuovo governo. At the beginning of a new government in Italy. For unity and peace in Italy. Day after tomorrow, on Tuesday, 25th October, I will be at the Colosseum to pray for peace in Ukraine. This is an interreligious summit for an interreligious summit called the Cry for Peace, organized by the community of Saint Egidio, and the Holy Father announcing that he will be present at this meeting on Tuesday at the Colosseum for the martyred people of Ukraine. I wish you a lovely Sunday, and please do not forget to pray for me. Enjoy your lunch, and arrivederci. The Holy Father encouraging the young people there to greet the pilgrims that are gathered in the square. And that brings us to the end of the Angelus of the 23rd October World Mission Sunday. I'm Father Paul Samasumo. On behalf of Vatican Media, big thank you to all who have made this transmission possible and to our partner broadcasters of Catholic Television, Catholic Faith Network, Shalom World Television Network, Shalom TV India, EWTN Television, Salt and Light TV, Atmadashan TV, Luminous Radio, and Radio Maria, England. Enjoy the rest of your day. Praise be Jesus Christ. Laudetur Jesus Christus.